Andrew Shue, Lafayette College, quarterback, number 7. It's an extreme honor. You know, I feel as though, you know, I've gotten to a point in my career where I've dedicated pretty much my entire life to football, and I've gotten to a point where, you know, I'm being recognized for something that, you know, is an extreme honor as far as an individual award, but, you know, that's not really the things that I've been striving for thus far in my career. You know, I've had a pretty disappointing career as far as, you know, winning games is concerned, and, you know, I'm up here, I'm trying to, you know, get the team together, and as is everybody else, and we're trying to, you know, strive forward and make progress and win this championship. So, you know, it's one of those situations where, like I said, it's an extreme honor, but, you know, it's gonna have to take a back seat to team successes as of right now. Again, like I said, it's an extreme honor. You know, those guys are very successful individuals at the same craft that I know what it takes to work just as hard for. So, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, you sit back and you take a moment of clarity and kind of just understand that, you know, not only are those guys, you know, guys that you can see on TV every Saturday and you know, soon to be on Sunday, guys that, you know, play the exact same sport and, you know, in some cases the same position that I do. So, like I said, it's an honor and, you know, it's a privilege to be mentioned with guys like that. You know, you wish nothing but the best for guys like that, and, you know, you just try and, like I said, take everything that you possibly can in the world of being a college athlete and try and use it to make you and your teammates better. So, you know, it's definitely something that I'm excited about, and I'm looking forward to this upcoming season. Well, you know, the biggest thing that I think, you know, has made me a successful quarterback up to this point in my career is the fact of the matter that I enjoy team success more than I enjoy individual success. You know, I've been part of a very mediocre high school team at best. You know, since I've been at Lafayette College, you know, we had a successful freshman year, which I didn't get to play in. Pretty mediocre last 2 years. So, you know, my drive for wanting to win is much greater than my drive for trying to gain individual awards and attributes. So, I think that's one of the biggest things that allows me to be successful as far as being a quarterback on this level is the fact that team success means a lot more to me than individual successes do. So, you know, I would like to think that comes with being a good leader and on and off the field, you know, not just between the white lines, but making good decisions off the field and making conscious efforts to make sure that you do everything right on a daily basis when it comes to, you know, being a good student in the classroom and being a good person as far as the perceptions of your peers. And, you know, I think it's something that is a 24-hour-a-day job. And, you know, a lot of people may take it lightly, but, you know, the likes of guys like Matt Barkley and Pierre Matthew and guys like that, I mean, I'm sure they know as well. It's a job that never ceases itself. So, you know, you definitely got to be conscious of everything that you do and say on a daily basis. And I think up to this point in my career, along with the fact that, you know, I believe that I'm a hard worker and I believe I care a lot about what I do in between the lines. I gotta say, you know, the biggest moment for me, I think, was last year when we were playing Colgate. We had a 2-minute drive where we needed to come down and drive for the tying touchdown in the last 2 minutes. And, you know, we got down there and we got the tying touchdown and we forced the game into overtime. Our offense came out and scored on our first possession of overtime, and we took the lead. And then, you know, my very, very good friend on the other side of the ball for our defense took an interception 102 yards to the end zone for a touchdown and then ended the game. And I think that, you know, just the heat of the moment and you know, the intensity of, you know, that you feel from the crowd and your teammates and on the other side of the ball as well, you know, I think it all turns itself into being, you know, that perfect football moment that everyone dreams of. You know, everybody charges the field and, you know, we end the game on a note like that. It was definitely one of those situations where everybody on the team and everybody in the stands felt every bit of emotion and every bit of passion that everyone was put into moments. And not just moments like that, but, you know, moments like that make up an entire season. So I think, you know, along with that, you know, definitely my first touchdown pass, you know, as a Lafayette Leopard, and, you know, getting my first little bit of college playing time was definitely one of the top moments that I've had, you know, just finally reaching that point where, you know, I'm on the field and I'm starting to make the right decisions and I'm starting to do everything the right way that I've been striving for since I got here. You know, I definitely think that those are two times where I would definitely like to put on my top five list of all time. Well, growing up, I was always a three-sport athlete. I was football, baseball, basketball since I can even remember. You know, I have the most supportive family in the entire world. You know, up until this day, I still have very, very big crowds of family at every single game that we play, home or away. You know, through high school, it was always the same way. I have a very big extended family, lots of cousins, and, you know, all of us are into sports. So, you know, if I wasn't doing something, someone was playing some sport somewhere, and, you know, my family was always actively involved in all of that. So, you know, I have, you know, the best mother in the world, the best sister in the world. You know, I have a very dedicated father to always making sure he's there for me on game day. And, you know, I have one of the best people in the world in my heart who, you know, is just as supportive as, you know, my mother is. And I think it's one of those things where a strong family background and a strong family following and support system is essential to any athlete. You know, I think it helps immensely, you know, growing up through the years. And once you get to the college level, it's one of those things that, you know, is a backbone to some guys that, you know, may necessarily be far from home, or even if they are close to home, having them there on Saturdays to support you and be out there and, you know, have someone to look up to in the stands wearing your jersey and, you know, come out of the locker room at the end of it. So, coming from a small town in Danville, PA, you know, not really too much to do. Really just stayed active and tried to play sports as much as I possibly could and you know, do the normal things kids try to do growing up. But, you know, like I said, it was a good place to come from because it allowed you to really stick close to your roots and stay close to home and keep very, very tight-knit with that family background. And like I said, big, large, extended family and one of the most supportive and loving families that I could ever ask to be a part of. So I'm definitely very blessed to come from where I come from and have the things that I have in my life. So it's definitely one of the top factors of why I am where I am today. I would say first and foremost, you know, Lafayette is a private institution. You know, we only have about 2,500 kids in our entire school. So it's most certainly not a USC or an LSU or, you know, a Penn State or of those likes. You know, it's definitely it's a smaller school. You know, the student following for athletics isn't exactly the highest that it would be at major Division I universities. But, you know, I think that that's what makes our team and the guys that we, you know, those guys that we hang out with on a daily basis that much closer. You know, you tend to have to make your own memories here at Lafayette and do things kind of your own way. But, you know, all the while doing things that, you know, you're going to have memories about just as well. So, I can definitely say that our college experience here has been a positive one for me and the rest of my senior class and, you know, the other best friends that I've come to know here. You know, I can count my best friends on two hands and, you know, all of them just about have come from Lafayette. So, definitely one of the better decisions I ever made in my life to come here and give my commitment to Coach Devani and Lafayette. You know, we definitely made the best out of a situation that is, you know, one that I'm going to remember for the rest of my life. So definitely an incredible experience and definitely have some memories that I'm going to be able to look back upon for a long time. Oh, wow. Probably something that I wouldn't want to share with too many people. The first thing that jumps to my mind would be my freshman year spring. I was out. We were playing. It was practice one day. And, you know, my coach had called in a play and it was just about near the end of practice, and my defensive coordinator was kind of screwing around a little bit and threw one of our defensive tackles in at middle linebacker, and he's about 6'3", 305 pounds maybe at the time, and I dropped back, and I threw a vertical over the middle, and the big old defensive lineman intercepted me. So that's definitely been something that's hung with me for the last 2 or 3 years. My coach has never let me live that one down. My teammates are still here and let me live that one down. So, you know, regardless of whatever successes I may have, both individually and as a unit, you know, everyone seems to let that one stick with me. So, Definitely a moment I won't forget, but it would like to be one that I could try and put in the back of my memory bank as quickly as possible. Normal stuff, you know. I have a fairly high, you know, I wear a polo a lot. You know, I'm a big Nike guy. You know, I don't really wear Nike, you know, if we were to go out, you know, maybe and hit the public scene a little bit. But you know, as far as just hanging out with my friends and you know, going out and doing anything that we might be doing on a daily basis, you know, I'm obviously Nike and Jordan, and you know, I love shoes. You know, I'm a big collector of Jordan shoes and Nike shoes. So, you know, normal things that I think you would expect from athletes. You know, at most schools, you know, I'm a guy that, you know, I take fairly good care of myself. You know, I like to make sure that if I step out, you know, I'm keeping a positive image. You know, both socially and you know, physically. So. It's definitely one of those things that I think if you ask anybody, you know, look good, feel good, play good isn't just about playing on the field. It's one of those things that you can take with you everywhere you go on a daily basis. So, you know, I take a little bit of pride in the way that I dress and the things that I wear. So, you know, just you know, nothing too crazy. You know, just a little snippet about, you know, the things that I like to dap myself up in every now and again. Andrew Shoup, Lafayette College quarterback, number 7, and this is the College Football Performance Awards watch list. All of Lafayette Leopards that have turned into this interview, my teammates, most importantly, you know, we're out here working hard, we're in here, up here in the summertime, and you know, nothing tells me and the rest of my teammates how much we all care and are dedicated to this and all the work that we're putting in so far this summer. The Lafayette fans, you know, we look forward to your support, and we thank you for the support that we've gained thus far. You know, we hope that you guys continue to fill up Fisher Stadium and follow us to our away games in our pursuit of winning a championship that is long overdue. And, you know, to everyone else in the Lafayette community, you know, we, again, appreciate the support and hope that it can continue and hope that we can, you know, follow up this year and bring one home for you.